So, about a month ago, the YouTuber Zack Freedman, the person I mentioned in my last video about Nerf Blasters, released a really cool 3D printed project called Gridfinity. It would allow the user to print little containers that they can use to sort bits, put screws in, even hold markers, and just assemble it in a grid formation so that everything is visible. And you can quickly just reach out and find the part that you want. So I thought, why not print it? Why not try out this concept? Because to me, that sounds awesome, and it would allow me to just quickly find it, stuff that I'm looking for, quickly organize, quickly assemble, quickly be able to do stuff, and it's awesome. And it's taken me a month to get to this point where I thought, maybe I should make a video about it now. Maybe I should show off my progress printing these containers, this Gridfinity. Here's a drawer full of containers. In this drawer right here, we've got all my screws I have, my 632s. My camera setup's weird right now. I have it, well, jankily hanging from on top of my monitor. It's weird. But I've got my 632s, my 440s. Wait, no, these are M screws. I've got my M screws right here, my 632s, my 440s, my M nuts and washers. I've got a box of 632 by 2 screws right here. Haven't put this in a Gridfinity bin yet because it's a big box. Let's see if I can zoom this out really fast. Before I had all the screws in containers like this, these little plastic box containers that aren't really that good. They have the labeling right here for all the screws. But they're just chunky. They're just too chunky in my opinion. And if I want to find a 440, all I see is this label. I don't see it say 440 on the lid. I open up and then I have to match. Okay, so I'm looking for a 440 3/8. And I have to, okay, so that's that slot, so that'd be right there. Which that's annoying. And so with Gridfinity, I'm able to just be like, okay, I need a 440 3/8 screw. That's this container, 440 3/8. This one right here. See, it's that easy. It's just in a little container. And that's just one example of Gridfinity. And this one is I believe the 3 by 1, yeah, the 3 by 1 by 6 5 compartment container. I believe that's the sizing for this one. And some other examples I have include this. I was able to sort all my resistors into a little grid container. This is the 5 by 1 by 3 compartment container. It's really nice. It's really cool looking too. I was able to just stick the little resistor ohm count on the little tabs. I've also sorted breadboard cables into these. And they're just neatly organized like this. They're all in their own little containers, which makes it way easier when I'm looking in the drawer next to my desk for, breadboard cables. And also, because how they're designed, you can just stack them on top of each other. If you want to just store them away, just continually stacking them, which is really cool. Makes it easy to organize everything out of sight, out of mind, or organized out of sight, out of mind. It makes it way easier. And then we've got another little container. This is a 2 by 1 by 6 three compartment, which I'm using to hold LEDs. Just all the different colors of LEDs in there. And that makes it easy for me to just reach into the drawer and be like, okay, I need a red, a green and a blue LED. And it's easy. I can just reach into the containers for them. And it's just nice. Like, it's organized. Everything has a place now. And before, all these LEDs were sorted into a little plastic baggie, like this little baggie. I've got a bunch of these just lying around now. And as I said before, like with the screws, I got all these components in boxes like this. Just in little baggies. I still need to print some more containers for these. I think they're capacitors and transistors, little switches and stuff. Like, I need to print more containers still. This is going to be an ongoing project for as long as I continue to have parts that need to be sorted. And because of their shape and their size, I'm able to just print whatever container I need, whatever size, and just have everything sorted where they need to be. This one I was having for switches and buttons. So I can just easily have them sorted in little containers. And they're really nice. Like, they take a little bit long to print. They take a little bit of time to print. This one, the one, one-sized ones, these containers right here, I can say for sure they took about 2 hours to print. I believe it was 2 hours to print each of these, at a 10% infill, 0.2, I believe, or layer height. Or extrusion height, whatever. But they took about 2 hours a piece to print, okay? That's not a long time. Sure, that's not a long time. But then we get to containers like, let's put these away. But then we get to, like, this container. This, the 5x1x3 compartment container. This took a whopping, I believe it was 8 hours to print. This took 8 hours to print. It's not because of the complexity or anything like that. It's just physics, just travel distance and everything. But these containers don't really use a lot of filament, which is really nice. They don't use a lot of filament. They're easy to print, and they are just nice. So, yeah, I just want to make that a really quick video about an amazing project that Zack Freedman had released, Gridfinity. And it has a lot of community support. A lot of people have already created a lot of their own grid-based containers. And sure, I only showed a few of the containers here. I didn't show all of them. But even Zack has made it his own large collection of containers. He's made containers that you can use as little drawers that you can put little windows on so you can see through them. He's made containers that can hold calipers, containers that can be put on top of your 3D printer. He's made a lot of different configurations for these, and it's amazing. And the community has made even more containers, even more variations. And it just allows for an almost infinite possibility to be used with these. And it makes it really easy just to organize and display all of your tools, all of your wires, everything that you need, just easily in one place. And, I mean, what hobbyist wouldn't like that? Or even a professional, what professional wouldn't like something like that? Where they can just quickly be able to find what they're looking for and be able to just go, yeah, that's what I need. That's what I need to finish this project and then just get it done with. Just do it. So yeah, this was Gridfinity. This is an amazing project. Thank you, Zack, for creating another amazing video and just showing off something that you yourself are using in your setup, I believe, and allowing us, the viewers, to download and use it too. That's just amazing, in my opinion. Gridfinity is awesome, but what's even more amazing is my Patreon supporters. Everyone who has supported me, all my followers on Patreon, Twitter, YouTube, all the social medias. You guys are awesome. Without your guys' support, I'm not able to do projects like this. I probably wouldn't be motivated to do projects like this so I can show you all what I'm doing. But because of y'all, I'm able to do this, and I'm really thankful for y'all's support. If you'd like to support me, you can easily do it by just subscribing on YouTube, just liking my content, and be able to get other people to see this, or just supporting me on Patreon for as low as $1 a month. That would be amazing. With just 25 people donating at $1 a month, I'd be able to buy another spool of filament every single month, which is awesome, because then I'm able to print more projects like this, and I'm able to show off more things like this. And yeah, with all of y'all's support, I'm able to do projects. So yeah, hope y'all have a good day. Hope y'all do amazing projects, and keep on doing this hobby. This hobby is amazing.